fans, welcome back to the channel. It's nice having you guys here. Today I'll be jumping in for my wife. She's having a busy week, so I just thought I'd jump in. So we'll be talking today about difficulties faced by small or starting YouTubers, which I think this channel falls in that category. So actually discussing the difficulties we face and maybe propose solutions. And don't forget, feel free to leave your comments in the comment section down below, and if you have better ideas, you can always interact so everybody grows together. So yeah, so we'll go in. I think the first difficulty faced by starting YouTubers is the choice of gear, like filming gear. Starting YouTube sometimes is viewed as being expensive, but considering you have to buy your camera, lighting and all that. But the good news is you don't always have to buy all those things when you're just starting up. You can use your phone if you have a really good phone. That depends on the kind of phone you use. Yeah, if not, if you have, you saved a little and you want to get into the camera, so yeah, you can go for a standard camera, like the DSLR camera. So an advice I think would help would be going for an average camera but a good lens, because buying a very good camera with the kit lens is what comes with the camera, the images or the quality will not be that good. But going with an average camera and a very good lens, you produce wonderful images and it's going to save you some coins. Remember, if you're filming with your phone, try not to film like this. Always you need to turn your phone horizontally, so you need to be filming this way. Try not to place it this way because the video is going to be a little weird. And also, starting off, you don't need to go with lighting and all that. Just try to film during the day. Natural light is always the best. Yeah, so that's going to help a lot to cut costs. Yeah, so going into the next difficulty will be ideas. Yeah, maybe before starting up your YouTube channel, you've had the time or to write down your ideas and all that, but maybe it just takes a month and you're out of ideas. Yeah, and the question is, what next do you film? What's your next topic? What do your viewers want and all that? An easy way is for you to know your niche. Starting YouTube, you have a passion. Either you're a sports person, you want to talk about sports, you love politics, you want to talk about politics, you love fashion. So that really gives you a direction you want to go. It makes it easier for you to choose your topics. Secondly, getting ideas. You can always get ideas from YouTube itself. You can not exactly copy, but you can get video ideas from other YouTubers who have been on YouTube, like taking their titles. But remember, you have to do your own research and put in your own personality, your own experience into the story. Everybody's story is different. The viewers out there want to hear what you have to offer. They want to hear your own path and your own experiences. That's why they come to your channel. Another thing you can do is always bring in a friend. If you're out of ideas, bring in a friend. There's always so much interaction. Maybe, for example, if you're out of ideas, you can bring in maybe your girlfriend and you can throw in a topic like, let's talk about our dream wedding, for example. I'm sure you guys are going to go on for hours and maybe next 3 hours, from the flower, the cake, and yeah, it's going to be endless. Ideas still, you can do a vlog. If you're out of creative ideas, you can do a vlog. People are interested to see your daily life. They're interested to know where you live, what you do every day. And mind you, you must not do what the big YouTubers do. Maybe they've spent some time on YouTube, they have the finances, they have the gadgets and everything. You must not follow the flashy style. You can't afford that, you're just starting. We are two down. The next difficulty is consistency. So many YouTubers, new YouTubers, have the ideas, everything is set, but they don't just have the time. The truth is, coming to YouTube, most people have their 9-to-5, 9-to-6 jobs. You have to do that, then come and find time to do YouTube. You come back, you're tired, you're exhausted, and you have your other chores to do. So what you can do in this case, and it's what we do, you have to film videos when you get a free day or your day off. You can use it to film maybe 2-3 videos, which is going to take you for the whole week, and maybe you have a backup video. The next difficulty actually is one of the main difficulties new YouTubers face, is not getting the views or the expected results from the videos. You've put in hours of research, filming and editing, and you put the video out there and you don't get in as much views as you expected, or hardly get any subscribers. Yeah, it can be demotivating, it can throw you off for a moment, but that shouldn't be the case. What you can do is, as a new YouTuber, you need to spread the word, you need to network, you have thousands of friends. You need to tell your friend to extend the word to his or her friend. That's how it goes. And before starting YouTube, most of us already have large social media accounts on Facebook, Instagram, and Snapchat. There are so many. Those are platforms you can use to promote your new channel. And starting YouTube, you should know your life is automatically out there. It depends on you how much you want to put out there, but you're already out there. So there's no need being shy. You should go all the way, promote your channel, send it to friends, and there's no limit. You should keep sending until you get the positive feedback. You know, it's like music on the radio. The first time you hear a soundtrack, it doesn't really strike you. There's some music like that. It doesn't really strike you, but because you hear that sound every day on the radio, automatically you find yourself one day singing it. You don't even know how. That's how much you should push your channel. So the next and the fifth, I think we're at the fifth difficulty faced by small and growing YouTubers, is the finance. Starting YouTube, you're totally dependent on your income from your 9-to-6 job or from your savings you've kept aside for the past month or the past year. So once you start YouTube, you start taking away from those savings, you start spending extra from your income. As a new YouTuber, what you can do is don't focus more on those videos where you have to buy. There's so many ideas out there, you don't have to buy anything. I'll give you an example. If you're into sports, there's the NBA transfer, there's the football transfer window. You know, there's this player being transferred from this club to this club. Guys are always interested in those kind of news. The same thing goes to fashion, the same thing goes to whatever niche you are into. So you can focus more on those kind of topics. We don't involve always buying. It only takes time. You're going to grow as long as you put in the work. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching, and remember to leave your comments down if you have better ideas, and yeah, just drop the comments and interact, and let's share how to grow and help those coming in new, so we can all grow together. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to click the subscribe button. I think it's down here or here, I don't know. Yeah, so thank you, see you guys.